In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The Lord God lives in his holy temple, yet abides in our midst. Since in baptism Alistair became God's temple, and the Spirit of God lived in him, with reverence we bless his mortal body. Our opening hymn is "On Eagle's Wings, you who dwell in the shelter of the Lord," the first hymn on the order of services.
Mm-hmm.
If you'd like to please sit down. Richard and Nicola are going to say a few words about their brother.
Thank you all for coming today. Words don't speak loudly enough of how much we will miss Alistair, how much of a difference he has made to everyone's lives. As I look out today, I see so much pain and hurt in everyone's eyes, pain that is measurable and indescribable. We are so happy to see how many people he had in his life. Ali was my baby brother. I remember when Mum brought him home, he was so small and so adorable. I couldn't wait to help look after him, bathe him with my mum. We had so many memories growing up, it's so hard to just pick one. Every moment spent with him was unpredictable, yet enjoyable. A light has truly gone out in this world, but is one that will live on through us all. I've got a poem that I want to read. We little knew the day that God was going to call your name. In life we loved you dearly, in death we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you didn't go alone. For part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us peaceful memories, your love is still our guide. And though we cannot see you, you are always at our side. Our family chain is broken and nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, the chain will link again. Thank you.
Sometimes when I spoke to Alistair, I got the impression at times he felt alone. But as I witness the love and support he has from everyone, I know that he is not alone and has never been alone. I would like to thank you all for your presence today and being there for him, especially when he has been in need. Alistair, if there were a motto which best described you, it would be that you worked hard and partied harder. And it's comforting to know that you lived life doing the things you enjoyed and wanted to do, regardless of sometimes what I had to say. Alistair, you were a caring person to your family, your friends, the patients you treated, and even those you didn't know. You were brave to stand up for what you thought was wrong, and courageous to find your own identity and figure out who you were in the world. I'm so proud to call you my brother. We shared so many things through our lives together, from experiences, scars, to material things like computers, Bluetooth speakers, and bikes. It got to the point where you didn't need to ask anymore to borrow what you needed. I could describe you as my alter ego, in that you were the life and soul of the party, and I was Bar Humbug, as you once called me. But you got the rhythm and dance moves, and I shamefully ended up with two left feet. In losing you, I feel as I've lost a part of me. And not because my friends would call you a little Richie boy at school. So many of us lost a brother on November 30th. Our hearts are heavy in weight, and we are missing you dearly. Look after yourself, little brother. And our loved ones who you are with now. I look forward to when we are together once again. We love you so much.
We now stand. We begin this celebration of God's love by turning to him and asking his forgiveness for our failure to love. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. You are the firstborn of all creation. Christ, have mercy. You are the good shepherd leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Alistair, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. If you'd like to sit down for the first reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God. As scripture says, by my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall praise God. It is to God, therefore, that each of us must give an account of himself. The word of the Lord.
As our psalm, we will remain seated and we will sing the hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful. Please stand to greet the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. And I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. And you know the way to the place where I'm going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. If you please sit down. When it comes to celebrating funerals, there are two schools of thought in the church. And the schools of thought about what you should wear. There are those who say you should wear white, and those who say you should wear purple. And we wear those colours not as a sign of mourning, but because in church circles, in liturgy circles, purple is a sign of preparation. We wear it during Lent as we prepare for Easter, and we wear it during Advent as we prepare for Christmas. Whereas white is a sign of celebration and the resurrection. So some churches always wear purple in the Catholic Church, and some always wear white. And here in this parish, we're among the white wearers normally to proclaim the resurrection. But at this particular time of the year, it's more appropriate, I think, that we wear purple. Because we gather here today during Advent, a time of preparation and a time of hope. We gather as a people of hope. And the reason we have hope is because of what we will celebrate next Tuesday. The coming among us of God made a man. That fact. The fact that God cares for the world so much, and God cares for his creation so much, and God cares for the human beings in whose image he created, in whose own image he created so much, he came and walked this world with us so that we could know his love, and we could see his love, and we could understand his love. And so we gather as people of hope. We shouldn't be here at all, in one sense. It's the last place any of us expected to be at this moment in Alistair's life. It wasn't planned, it wasn't expected, and we can't make sense of it. But in the midst of that pain, in the midst of that struggle, in the midst of that perhaps anger and denial, we are still a people of hope. Because we believe that God loves us. And we believe that God wants every single one of us to reach that fulfillment in his love. So we gather as people of faith that this life and this world and that our destiny is to be in eternity with God. And we gather as people of thanksgiving. What you said at the beginning, the two of you, that life you described, it is a life to be thankful for. I often think that gospel you picked and all those rooms in our Father's house, he's not talking about heaven at all. He's not talking about the future. He's talking about now. Because everywhere God's love touches, there a room in our Father's house is created. And all those things you described, there were rooms in our Father's house. When your mum brought him home and you loved him, God's love at work. God's house created one of those rooms. When you shared, another of those rooms. When you struggled and played and grew up together, all those rooms you created. And those other rooms too that all of you can describe, and I'm sure afterwards when you come back to the hall, you will describe many of them as you celebrate his life and tell the stories of his life. And when they're told with joy, and when they're told with thanksgiving, and when they talk of care and love and enjoyment, you're actually talking about God's love at work in this world. So that's why we gather in hope. That's why we gather in faith. And that's why we gather in thanksgiving. This life that was cut so short, tragically cut so short, with all the dreams it had and all the hopes it had, but still, as you said, he is there waiting for us, we pray, and that one day he in his turn will welcome us. Welcome us into the fullness of life where there is no more pain and there is no more discomfort and there is no more imperfections, but that we live that fullness of life in and with and through God. It's that fullness of life that we all search for and that ultimately is only to be found there with God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We stand now for our bidding prayers. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ his Son from the dead. So with confidence we turn to him, asking him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Alistair, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That God may deliver the souls of his servant Alistair from punishment and the powers of darkness, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That God in his mercy may blot out all his offences, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That the bishops and the priests of the church and all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express in action the word they proclaim. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for a moment in silence for our own personal needs, for Alistair, for all those whom we love. O God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers that we offer for our departed brother Alistair. Cleanse him and all the faithful departed of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you'd like to sit down for the offertory, and during the offertory we will sing the hymn, Praise to the Lord the Almighty. And if two people could bring the dish of hosts and the wine and the water from the table at the back, please. pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise, the glory of his name, for our good and all the good of his holy church. As we humbly present to you, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings for the salvation of your servant Alistair, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. If you'd like to stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ who is our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. If you'd like to kneel down for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, till you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Vincent our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Alistair, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. If you'd like to stand. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. It is the custom in the Catholic Church that we can only invite those who've actually been baptized or received into the church, formerly as Catholics, to come forward to receive communion. If for any reason you're unable to receive communion, you are more than welcome to come forward to receive a blessing. If when you arrive at the front, you either cross your arms across your chest or incline your head, I will know to give you a blessing. If you wish to come forward, if you'd like to come forward now, if you're not coming forward, if you'd like to sit or kneel, whichever you find more comfortable, during the distribution of communion, we will sing the hymn, "Lead Kindly Light."
Body of Christ.
Amen.
The
Christ. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The body of Christ. 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 Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Just have something brief to share. I want to start by thanking Richard and Nicola for a beautiful eulogy. Really summed up my cousin beautifully, so just a few words. I'm looking for my cousin. He's right there, strapped in a high chair, a few years old, acting like some mad bear. A restless soul, moving non-stop, This chubby-faced rascal is no match for this child safety lock, Pop. I'm looking for my cousin. He's on a mound chucking rocks, one by one. Nobody knows when he'll stop. He's in the Philippines to help. We're in the Philippines to help the family out, fulfilling the migrant dream to build the family house. So imagine my frustration. While everybody else is building up their hopes, he's throwing away the foundation. But little Ali's only 8, so he ignores what is said, too small to understand our plans are over his head. I'm looking for my cousin. All I can see is the back of his head, framed by the glow of a computer screen. These days, he's good friends with people I've never seen. Some of them, you might know them if you had a dial-up modem. I found myself looking for my cousin at Christmas parties. He wasn't present. Upon reflection, it was evident we were too wrapped up in festivities to solve the missing Ali mystery. The same at summer barbecues and other events, to smuggle out food and leave was his only intent. I'm looking for my cousin, but apparently he's out raving. No doubt misbehaving, chasing a baseline somewhere, dancing like he doesn't care. Sharing a beer amid flashing lights and smoke in the air. I'm looking for my cousin, but he's lost in his thoughts. We're sitting in my car for one of those talks about homespun philosophies and the possibility of finding love. I tell him from experience that it's truly the best drug. Still, he swears that he's numb. In later days, I've come to learn that he hid his joy elsewhere, in the hearts of friends that he held close and dear. Today, I still find myself looking for my cousin. I know I'll only find him when I discover a place of peace, for a piece of him lives in our collective memories. Puzzled by our loss, so we come together, but we do so in the hope that we'll see him much better. We are the sum total of Alistair's love. His poem is for my cousin looking down from above.
Let us pray. We stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Alistair may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Alistair. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Alistair again and enjoy his friendship. And although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. So let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. We now sprinkle the coffin with holy water, a reminder that in his baptism, Alistair was restored to the image and the likeness of the God who called him to being and created him in love. We then surround it with incense, the smoke of the incense, a sign of our prayers rising to our Father in heaven, but also a sign of honor and respect for this person who was, who is, and who always will be a temple of the Holy Spirit and the presence of God's love and life in the lives of so many people. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Alistair, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness, of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, now with you and our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And to you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Alistair, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace now, let us take Alistair to his place of rest. The committal will take place in Cheshunt Cemetery, and everyone is welcome to join us there. If for any reason you are not going to the cemetery, the commemoration and celebration of Alistair's life will continue in the parish hall, the hall in the parish centre, when we come back from the cemetery. If you're not going to the cemetery and you wish to go into the hall, the entrance is through these doors here on your left as you come up the church.
Vultures and thieves at your back. Stop. keeps on twisting. Keep on building the lies that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Escape one last time. It's easier to believe in this sweet madness, all this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees in the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark.
Sometimes I'm beaten, sometimes I'm broke, 'cause sometimes this city is nothing but smoke. Is there a secret? Is there a code? Can we make it better? 'Cause I'm losing the hope. Tell me how. Tell me how to breathe in and feel no hurt. Tell me how, 'cause I believe in something. I believe in us. After the wreckage, after the dust, I still hear the howl, I still feel the love. Over the rise of all the noise, through all the world, I still hear your voice. So tell me how to be in this world. Tell me how to breathe in and feel no hurt. Tell me how, 'cause I believe in something. I believe in love. Tell me when the light goes down, that even in the dark we will find a way. Tell me how, 'cause I believe in something.